Hello everyone, this is Ricey and welcome to my channel, The Quest for Wealth. I have published this video in the past and I did receive quite a number of negative feedback on the quality of the audio of the video, and therefore I decided probably it will make sense to republish it with better audio and editing. Potentially we create a whole new video about it and have more information, more palpable information that would be more useful for the viewers. So I hope you like it. I did include some more information about it, and watch on. Canada has got a total population of almost 40 million. The population of Canada is equivalent to almost the population of the state of California in the US. And out of this 40 million people, only 2% lives in New Brunswick. Almost half of 40 million lives in Ontario. And 2% of 40 million is about 800,000. People, and you can only imagine this amount of population is quite small, and therefore the government of New Brunswick has established its onus to establish the economy of the province, and one of the programs is essentially immigration. Immigration or growth of population is one of the concerns of the government. Now, I do understand that many of my viewers are immigrants, and therefore the top three most popular cities to live in New Brunswick are Moncton, St. John, and Fredericton. The Greater Moncton area consists of Dieppe, Riverview, and Moncton. So those three communities are called existentially as Greater Moncton area. Moncton is the largest city in New Brunswick. When you say largest, meaning the most populous city, and it has recently, back in 2016, if I remember correctly, back in 2016, it overtook St. John to be the largest city in New Brunswick, meaning the population of Moncton became bigger than St. John. Now, Moncton is certainly a safe and clean city to live in. There are areas in Moncton that are not quite palpable to the eyes. These are mainly the main street and the downtown area of Moncton, or the mountain road. But the thing is, if you are new to the province or to the city, and chances are you wouldn't have a vehicle. So therefore, it is certainly a requirement or an obligation almost for you to live in those areas, because of the bus system. The transportation system is essentially ubiquitous in that area. One of the beauty of living in Moncton is that it is home to various and a variety of privately owned companies, privately owned either small to medium companies, or multinational corporations as well. People do have diverse options when it comes to employers, not just the Irving owned companies. Not necessarily that there's something wrong with working with the Irving, absolutely not. I did work for them at one point in my life. At least there are options for the population to be employed with a different kind or a different breed of employers or corporation. Moncton is home to various call center companies such as Tech Mahindra, Rogers, Nordia. You have got the Royal Direct as well, and it is home to other multinational companies such as ExxonMobil as well, and the world's biggest or second biggest drilling company in the industry of oil and gas is located or headquartered in Moncton, and the company is called Major Drilling. This company's headquarters is along St. George. And not only that, TD Bank, as I have mentioned in my previous video, is that TD Bank moved their corporate headquarters here in the city, and therefore created more diversified options for population in terms of employment. Now, Walmart, the publicly traded company, which is a US company, recently made its announcement that they will make a private investment here in the city, wherein they will put up a warehouse and which will be the hub of the Walmart Atlantic here in the whole of the maritime provinces. This again is another diversification in terms of employment opportunities to the population, which is absolutely good. It's a good thing that we are not, or New Brunswickers are not tied or are not restricted or engulfed mainly with the idea of working for the companies owned by the Irving family. Again, not that there's something wrong with that, but at least there is diversification being created in the economy through other private corporations or private capitalization. I can describe Moncton as a multicultural community. Moncton is home to a variety of minorities from Asia, from Eastern Europe, from Latin America as well, and from Africa. So if you come here, you will see a whole Ragnarok of people of diverse background, diverse culture, diverse languages, diverse feel to the community, and therefore it has more life to it. I'm a proponent of the idea that diversification is essentially a life of a certain community, and diversification drives the creativity of a community and economic growth of any community. If you see a certain community being diverse culturally, being diverse economically, you can definitely assume that there is a huge future or economic future within this community, and this is certainly what Moncton is right now. Now, as I mentioned earlier in this video, the government of New Brunswick has established its onus to grow the population of the province through immigration, and I can definitely say that majority of the immigrants coming into the province do settle here in Moncton, and this is the primary reason that Moncton was able to overtake St. John when it comes to the growth of population. When it comes to language was one of my major concerns when I moved here to Moncton. To be very honest with you, none of the three cities here that we will discuss in this video, none of these three cities actually require any French speaking ability, unless you would want to work in a government position. And if you also decided to reside in the northern part or the cities or the communities that are nearer to Quebec, then certainly you will have to speak French. Otherwise, if you decided to live here in Moncton or in Fredericton or in St. John, absolutely, English is more than enough for you to get by. The second best city to live in New Brunswick is Fredericton, or to the locals or to the residents of New Brunswick, we call it Freddy. Freddy is the capital of the province, and Freddy is also home to various multinational companies such as Salesforce, IBM. Those are just a few of them. And Freddy being the capital city, it does have the main seat of the government, the legislative seat of the government, the museums, and the official seat of the governor of the province. Now, when it comes to comparing the number of multinational companies in Freddy and Moncton, Freddy is not comparable to the number of companies that are operating and has got office here in Moncton. There are more companies here in Moncton than there is in Freddy. But Freddy, again, is a beautiful town. It's quaint, it's peaceful, it's calm. It's a kind of place that if you wanted to unwind and just be with yourself and be by yourself, drive to Freddy. It's only a 2-hour drive from Moncton, and you'll be coming back happy. it's a very quaint little town. Now, the third best city to live in New Brunswick is, of course, as we all know it, is St. John. Now, St. John is the industrialized, or the most industrialized city in the whole of New Brunswick. St. John is wholly or solely dependent on the businesses and operations of the Irving family. Most, if not all, of the Irving family's factories are in St. John, and the Irving family has got a plethora of businesses. Steel, they have it. Do you think of food, they have it. If you think of pulp and paper mill, they have it. If you think about oil and gas, they have it, or energy as a whole, they have it. Again, media, they have it. So the Irving family, I can certainly say that the Irving family own and operate the economy of St. John. If you decided to live in St. John, then chances are you will be employed by one of the companies of the Irving group of companies. It's either directly or indirectly, but you will be within the circle of these families' businesses. The Irving family is one of the richest family in the whole of Canada, and they employ one person out of 12 in the whole of New Brunswick. So you can only imagine how huge their operations are. Again, if you decided to live in St. John, chances are you would be working directly or indirectly with this family's businesses. And even if you decided to live in Moncton, really, either directly or indirectly, you will be also working with the Irving family. It's only such that, at least in Moncton, you have got other options when it comes to private employment. Now, working for the Irving group, as I have personally experienced, the Irving group is they're a generous company. At least with the oil and gas that I worked for, it's a generous company. One of the major consideration when it comes to living or residing in a city is the environment. St. John, being an industrialized city or community, you definitely should expect that because of the factories and manufacturing facilities that the family or the Irving family's businesses has, you can definitely expect that the environment is not something that is palpable to the eyes. The clouds that you see in the sky is not organic clouds. There are clouds emitted by the manufacturing facilities by these the companies. But then if you compare it to Moncton, here in Moncton, if you see a cloud, if you see a sea of clouds, those are organic sea of clouds. They're natural sea of clouds, and the same with Fredericton. And I can tell you right off the bat, really, with the rest of the cities here in New Brunswick, it is the same case, but not in St. John. I believe that the reason that most of the manufacturing facilities of the Irvings are in St. John is because of the port. The port of New Brunswick is in St. John, and it is being operated by the Irving family again, of course. Because of this port, they have got multiple door to the world and to the rest of the North American region for business and trade. Needless to say that the economy of St. John, or really of New Brunswick, is absolutely dependent on the businesses by the Irving family. Now, you will ask the question, of course, so which city really is the best city to live in? The answer to this question is very relative, because what's best for me may not be best for you, and what's best for you may not be best for the person sitting beside you. To me personally, if you consider diversification, employment, environment, economic independence somehow, I would say that Moncton really is the best option for an immigrant who does not have immediate family here. Now, if you had immediate family here, probably you have a different answer to that. If they live in St. John, probably St. John is something that you would consider. But to me, having no immediate family here, absolutely, Moncton is the best option for me. Thank you very much indeed. I hope you gained value in this video. If you did, please do consider to like, share, and subscribe.